and I thought I'd just have a quick catch up with you about what's going on here in my little cottage by the sea. I have got lots going on at the moment. I kind of thought that I would be winding down. Over this past year, those of you who are on my Patreon or, you know, visit me regularly here in Hastings, I have been sort of in a bit of a transitionary phase with my business. So I was a wedding dress designer and I did commissions, making things for film, TV, so on, and, you know, for private clients. I also taught and I still teach at my local college. So I teach pattern cutting. I go in and teach workshops for fashion students and so on. And yeah, it's just been lots of different things. And then I also obviously do this and set up Tara's School of Dressmaking on Patreon. And also I design and put out knitting and sewing patterns for those of you who like the same sort of thing that I like and want to sew along, knit along with me. I taught my last evening class of the 10-week course on Tuesday. We had a little Christmas party. Everybody brought nibbles in. We had mulled wine and that was lovely. And I start again in January. So I'll be stopping completely for a couple of weeks from about the 23rd of December. And then I will resume whenever that week is that I go back to the college. I haven't looked to see, but I have bought a new diary and I am getting super organised because behind the scenes and while I've been taking time to ponder, I have been organising myself and I am ready to rock and roll once we hit 2023. Very much looking forward to a break. I've got a ton of stuff to do over the next couple of weeks, including making a Christmas cake, which I hadn't thought I would do. So I will share that with you. I haven't decided what that's gonna be or what it's gonna look like. So that could be fun. I need to decorate still the dining room. I've put like bits out, but I just haven't really had a moment. So got some interior DIY stuff to do as well as decorate. And then I've got presents to make and I, what else? Books to recommend, mince pies to eat, all the good stuff. This evening, I'm off out with some dear friends just for our annual, which we haven't had since pre-COVID, drinky poos. It's sort of freelancers, people who work for themselves, who live locally, who are really good friends. But I must crack on and get on with filming. So I'm filming next week's YouTube video today. And yeah, I'm really, really looking forward to it. Teeny tiny hint. So I shall check in with you later, my lovelies. A bit wonky, but I thought before I have my breakfast and get on with my day, I would show you what I'm wearing. So you may recognise this dress. This was a Vampire's Wife DIY that I did. I'll try to remember to link it. Nice and long, got thermals underneath. So this dress is great because it's high and the sleeves are long and whatever. You can just put like about 10 thermal vests underneath, which is great. And then I've got thermal tights on and I have got my Lucrezia gilet, which is a Patreon exclusive project. So this is padded and it's got this Italian quilting, trapunto type quilting on it, which I show you to do. You get the motif and the, you know, all the pattern cutting and so on, and then you sort of tie it up. And I love it because it reminds me of a sort of like a Tudor noblewoman, and I quite like feeling like I'm wearing a doublet. So I've got that on, nice and warm, and goes nicely over sleeves. And then I found in my cupboard, I'm gonna do this really elegantly because you know me, I know how to pose. I've got my sheepskin boots on. These, I'd totally forgotten that I had them. They are quite redonkulous, but they are so warm. I bought them, oh gosh, about 18 years ago. I've had them so long and I hardly ever wore them. But in Arctic temperatures. They are super snuggly and cozy. They're from a company that used to be called the Celtic Sheepskin Company, but I don't know if they're still about or if they're still called that, but I'll have a look and see. It would be interesting. I used to buy lots of their stuff. I was never an UGG person, but I used to buy lots of their boots for my daughter and for me, and they had them in all lovely colours and their slippers were great. But yeah, got these out to keep my ankles and legs and feet warm. Honestly, my ability to speak astounds me sometimes. But that's my outfit for today in my very cold cottage by the sea.